Here's another example of us doing that same piecewise function stuff. So I'm going to begin with, I've got a nice quadratic at the top. And then my other function seems to be a square root function. Ooh, exciting. I'll begin with the quadratic. So the quadratic has got two transformations on it. One, it is being moved down by one. And second, it is going up twice as fast as it normally would be. It has been stretched vertically because of that two. Now, I know that because I've been doing this a bunch. You know what it is a way easier thing to do is just take that x value of 1, plug it in there, and see what you get. What is 1 squared times 2 minus 1? Well, it's 1. So I'm just plop. But you can also say, hey, it was supposed to be, it was supposed to be right here, but it's going up twice as much. And do the same thing on the other side. Normally it'd be there. I think the next point actually shoots off the graph. So that's all we'll really graph. So there's our quadratic. That's good enough. Next, we have our square root function. Our square root function normally would be starting right there, but it's been moved up by 2. So it's going to start right here now. It has another point, which is right there. Again, plug in some numbers, see how it looks. I was just checking my graph against my key. Yeah. So now that we've got that, now we need to figure out, okay, well, how much of this thing are we actually going to use? So the red one, we want all the places where x is less than 1. So here is our kind of cutoffs point. We need to be less than 1. So we want to be to the left of that line. Now, this is going to be a little tricky erasing, but you know what? I'll just kind of fill it back in. So we want anything less than 1. So we don't want this piece because that's bigger than 1. So that's no good. Let's put my square root function back together as I erase more of it. So let's see, we had a point there. There we go. So I want to be less than 1, so I'm going to use an open circle. If it's a less than, if it had been an equal to, I would have put a filled in circle there. And there's my graph for the red part. Still got to do the blue part. So x has got to be the greater than or equal to 1. So there's our cutoff point right there. We want to be greater than or equal to 1. We want to be to the right of that line. So I need to get rid of this kind of like beginning bit. We don't need that. This has got an equal to, so I'm going to use a filled in circle. Whoop. And there we go. We have got our function graphed. Sweet. Next, I need to determine the domain and range of this thing. So if I'm checking domain, I move across my graph from left to right, and I see if there is graph above or below me. I see graph up there, see graph up there, graph up there. At this point, it dips below it, but I can still see graph. I can see graph up here. And at this point, at the very end, I can still see graph, but it's just way up high. This thing continues to move up and out this way. So eventually there will be graph above me. So there are no problems with this thing's domain, which is all real numbers. We go from negative infinity to infinity. There was no trouble along the way. How nice. I'm going to erase all that. Let's get a little bit messy. All right. Next, I need to check my range. So as I'm moving up and down on this axis, can I see graph to my left or to my right? So here I actually see to my left and the right. Ooh, how great. So we got lots of graphs. So it's better to be double covered when it turns in terms of range. So we're definitely fine. In this middle spot, we've got it to the left, not to the right, but no big deal. We got it somewhere. Here we got left and right again, but it seems to get cut off down here. At this point, as we go down, there's nothing to the left and right. So it stops at that point. It doesn't go any lower than that. So our range, our lowest we go is -1, but we go up to infinity. We go up really high. We've got a filled in circle in terms of our y values and our x values at negative 1. Since it's filled in, we use a bracket. Next, we're checking where our function is increasing, decreasing, or constant. So we are increasing where the graph is going up, and we're checking where it is going up as we move from left to right. I would like an eraser, please. I'm just going to get rid of this junk in the middle. There we go. So on this point, our graph is moving up. So we move up along here. It makes a big jump up and then continues to move up as we move along there. It's not moving up as quickly, but it is still moving up. So since it is still moving up, it is still increasing. There's two schools of thought for whether you want to use a bracket or a parentheses at zero. If you want my opinion, I like parentheses, but in terms of increasing and decreasing, I don't really care which one you do. You can use a bracket, you can use parentheses, it's up to you. Don't really care. Where it's decreasing is along this point, right along here, we seem to be going down as we move from left to right. Don't follow the arrow of that's red. Look at that graph from left to right. As you move from left to right, from negative infinity to zero, it is going down. So we use a parentheses. It's going down, so it's decreasing. You can use a parentheses or a bracket again. Doesn't really matter. There's lots of schools of thought. You got to get to calculus for me to really explain why it should be what it is. Where it's constant, there's no point where it is constant, no point where it's perfectly flat. Yes, that square root looks a little bit more flat, but it's not really flat. It's kind of flat, but it's not really flat. So it's constant nowhere. Constant nowhere. And that's it for that one. Woohoo! Okay, one more of these graphs. So this one's got three parts to it. Whoa! We're going to deal with it the same way. Fortunately, two of those parts are linear. So I've got this linear piece here. I've got a absolute value function. Ooh, that's cool. And then the final one is just a boring linear. It's just an x. Well, how boring. Let's do that one first because it'll be easy. So I'm just going to go point, 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 point. Now, this one, there's going to be a lot of overlapping stuff. So just to kind of make our lives easier, I'm going to do that erasing step as I go. We're going to kind of graph and erase at the same time. That way we can hopefully have less graphs on top of graphs. And it'll be a little bit easier for us to work with. So we want just the points where x is less than negative 3. So here's our x value, negative 3. I just want the part that's left of it. So I can get rid of all this stuff that I just spent the time to graph. Ah! Oh, well. It is just a less than. It's not a less than or equal to. So we will put an open circle here at negative 3. Next is our absolute value. So it's just a regular absolute value. It's right here in the middle. It's not transformed whatsoever. So that is, see how this would have been like right on top of the orange line we would have had? So that's kind of why I did it that way. So here is our absolute value graph. Awesome, absolute value, done. Now, this one's got two restrictions. We want to make sure that we are between negative 3 and 1. So here's one of our boundaries, and then here is our other boundary. We want to be in between those two numbers. So I'm going to get rid of all this junk, bye. And I'm going to get rid of all this junk, bye, so that it's just in between negative 3 and 1. 1 has an equal to, so 1 is going to get a filled in circle. And then negative 3 has just a less than, so it's going to get an open circle. Done. Well, done for that one. Now we still got our last graph to do. Our last graph to do is at negative 3x plus 11. So that thing is starting way up here. Oh my gosh, that's way too tall. Well, here, let's cheat a little bit. We only care about when x is like greater than 2. So let's just kind of like start at 2 and just see what we get. So if we put 2 here, then it would be negative 3 times 2. That is 6. Negative 6 plus 11, that would be at 5. Ooh, that's right on the edge of our graph. Cool. Then 3 would be, well, now I can just use my slope. I can go down 3 over 1, down 3 over 1, down 3 over 1. So there's our line. Now I need to erase when x is less than 2. So that would be this stuff, which fortunately I didn't bother to even graph. However, at regular 2, it was supposed to be an open circle because we said open, it's a greater than. It doesn't have an equal to. That's the thing I'm trying to get to. It doesn't have an equal to, so it should be an open circle at that. And now we have graphed our piecewise function. Hooray! Let's identify our domain for this thing. So here we go. I'm gonna got this green line right here, and I'm looking to see if I have graph either above or below me. Right here, we've got that orange line below us covered, orange line below us covered. Right here at negative 2, I've got red line, but check right at negative 3. If we check down below us, the orange line is open. So there's no graph there. It's close to it, but not quite there, right at negative 3. So we're not saved down below with the orange one. We have the same story up above. Up above with that red one, it's also an open circle. So if we tried to put negative 3 into our function, we looked up here, we don't know where to put negative 3. It's not bigger than 2, so it doesn't go here. Negative 3 is not greater than negative 3, so it doesn't go here. And negative 3 is not less than negative 3, so it doesn't go there either. So negative 3 has got this little tiny gap in it. So we've got that, like, we've got to skip over negative 3. It doesn't belong. It has nowhere to go for our function. Right here, we're right on the line, but that's okay at the origin. We're fine there. However, we've got a little gap over there. We've got a gap at that spot because if we look above and below, we've got red line. Oh, dang it. We've got red line above us at 1, but right after 1, we don't have any more graph. It doesn't pick up again until we hit 2. That's when we pick up again and we get more graph. So our domain is actually quite complex for this one. We have, we start at negative infinity. We have a gap at negative 3. We pick up again right after negative 3, and we keep going till 1. Then we pick up again at 2 with a parenthesis, and we keep going to infinity. Oof, that is a complicated domain. Let's check our range. Hopefully our range won't give us as many troubles. So our range, we check the y values and we check, do we have graph to our left or our right? At this point, we've got both sides, so we're covered there. At this point, we only have blue graph to our right, but that's fine. As long as we got graph somewhere, we're okay. We still have, at this point, we have red and blue to our right, and we've got red to our right, so we're all set. We're all great there. Here we've got red and we've got blue that way, so we're okay. We've got blue that way. Oh, but once we reach to the top, the blue stops. That blue line stops at 5. It doesn't go any higher than 5. That's as high as it goes. It doesn't keep going. Down below, it keeps going. We've got that arrow down below, but at the top, it doesn't keep going. So our range stops at 5. So we're fine. There's no gaps. So we start at negative infinity and we go on our merry way until we hit 5. After 5, we have no graph as we continue to go up. So that is our range. Finally, let's take a look at increasing, decreasing, and constant. So we are increasing, So let's just kind of go through and see where are we going up. So here we're going up. So we're increasing here. Here we're going down, so we don't like that. Here's a little spot of increasing right there. And then this spot we're going down, so we don't like that. So here we're going down, we're decreasing, then we go back up, and then here we're decreasing as well. So the purple, we're increasing, and the teal, we're decreasing. So we're increasing from negative infinity, and then it seems we stop, we check our x values at -3. We've got a gap. And then there's that little chunk of increasing. It starts at 0 and it goes till 1. Again, you can put a bracket or parentheses. I got a filled in circle there. I feel like a bracket. Which one you want, I don't care for the very ends of these increasing or decreasing. I mostly care about the numbers. Why it should be increasing or decreasing at those endpoints, it takes calculus to determine that. So we're not going to really talk about that right now. That's all right with you all. So we're decreasing from -3, and we keep going until we hit 0. Put a parentheses or bracket here. I do not care. And then we pick up again, it looks like at 2, and we keep decreasing onwards to infinity. This one still doesn't have any place where it's flat. It's still not flat anywhere, so it is constant nowhere. And that's done.